The minimum wage increase has had a fraught battle to be included in the COVID aid bill. And unfortunately, people like Joe Biden, Kamala Harris seem all too willing to just do whatever the Senate parliamentarian says and boot it on down the road, a road where it seemingly has virtually no chance of actually being passed if it's not a part of this bill. Now, Bernie Sanders is an important figure in this battle because as the chair of the Senate budget committee, it's really up to him as to whether it's a part of that COVID aid bill. And so here at TYT, we've been trying to put pressure on him to not take it out with the hashtag don't kill it, Bernie. And it looks like, although we don't necessarily know in exactly what form, he is going to be forcing a vote on it, knowing that it might not pass, but that it will put every single senator, including especially every Democrat, on the record on this issue. And so he announced this tweeting at a time when millions of workers are earning starvation wages, when the minimum wage has not been raised by Congress since 2007 and stands at a pathetic $7.25 an hour. It is time to raise the minimum wage to a living wage. And on the what I call just an excuse, the parliamentarian is an excuse to not do it since they can be overridden. They have been removed in the past. If Kamala Harris wanted to do that, she could do that. She's not doing it, thus she doesn't want to do it. He says, my personal view is that the idea that we have a Senate staffer, a high ranking staffer, deciding whether 30 million Americans get a pay raise or not is nonsensical. We've got to make that decision, not a staffer who's unelected. So my own view is that we should ignore the rulings, the decision of the parliamentarian. And he said, to the best of my knowledge, there will be a vote on the minimum wage. We'll see what happens. I intend to offer the bill that will raise the minimum wage to $15 an hour, and we'll see how the votes go. If we fail in this legislation, I will be back. We're going to keep going. We are going to raise that minimum wage very shortly to $15 an hour. So we still have a lot to figure out what's going to happen, Viviana, but it looks like Bernie Sanders is not ready to give up on it as a part of this package just yet.
I mean, Bernie Sanders has never stopped fighting for the working people of this country, and we're so lucky to have him. But you know, Biden has been in office for just a couple of months now, and he's already broken several promises. You know, we are seeing some of the same behavior that we saw during the Great Depression when he was in office with Obama. You know, a lot of people lost their jobs back then. A lot of people never became employees again. They don't have any benefits anymore. I mean, this has been an ongoing problem for a while. And there was an excuse back then as to why they couldn't raise the minimum wage, because of the deficit, because of the recession, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And here we are, 2021, the future, and we're still in the same exact position. I mean, it's absolutely unheard of to expect people to live off of $7.25 an hour and get taxed heavily. It's just absolutely ridiculous. And it is something that should be put to a vote, because every single voter needs to know how their representative voted for this. Because I guarantee that, how many did you say? 30 million people, John? They need this money. They need this money. This is like life and death for these people. And this should be $25 an hour. 15 was the compromise like 10 years ago. And here we are, 2021, we're still dealing with $7.25 an hour. And you know, people assume that this is just your average kid going into McDonald's and working a fast food job. No, we have servers making $25 an hour. We have people who have been working at Walmart for decades, still making minimum wage. There are no benefits for these people. And we wonder why the country is falling into poverty. We wonder why there's a growing chasm between the 1% and the rest of us. And it's exactly for this reason, because they will continually exploit the working class just to continue to build wealth for the 1%. It is disgusting.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. They need the money. And also importantly, they were promised the money. They were promised the money in advance of the November election. They were promised the money in advance of the special elections in Georgia. They've been promised by Biden, by Harris, by a whole bunch of them. And but the parliamentarian. That's why they can't do the thing that they promised.
But here we are, John. We're he's saying he's not going to lower this. He's not going to get rid of the student debt, 10,000. What is that? Half a semester for most of these people?
Well, so Viviana, he's not gonna lower. I assume. So the reason that he's not doing that executive order, I have to assume, is the parliamentarian, right? I mean, after all, he could just sign an executive order. He's not doing it. What is your excuse in this particular case? And especially, by the way, let's say that you seriously are just like bowing down to the will of the parliamentarian. I really do want to do it, but they say that I can't. Okay, maybe as an act of good faith or like a show of good faith, do the one you can actually do. You could sign that executive order right now, but he's not. And so if that leads people to question his actual motivations, I can't imagine anything more reasonable than that.
I think we know what the motivations are, and it's what brought us Donald Trump. We are disillusioned with our current system, our current political system. Corporations have their hands deep into these guys' pockets, and they cannot move without approval. And it is something that we were afraid Biden was going to do. It was something that he promised he wasn't going to do. But now we already have broken promise after broken promise. We still have immigrant detention centers set up where they're putting kids. I mean, this is something he ran on. So it's really disgusting because Biden was the compromise. Obviously, you and I were really pro Bernie. There was a lot of people. There's people marching in the streets, millions across the country. We want change. And it's not just the left and it's not just progressives. The right needs change too. Mm-hmm. Now, because of racism and white supremacy, the right, that was a Freudian slip. The right has their own reasons who they want to blame. But really at the end of the day, it comes down to the exploitation that capitalism requires. Yeah. And this is just another example of that.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.